different today. Jeez, oh, that looks weird. I'm so close. What's up, Dennis? Can you hear me good? Does it sound all right? Wizard. I wanted to do it. I drew it up, I sketched it out. Just a quick little sketch. He's holding an airbrush and he's stirring his cauldron here. Drew it up. And then he has a vial here that he's dumping into the cauldron. And he has a crazy face, his little wizard hat. I'm probably thinking of making it say like Createx or something against his vial. But we're also gonna add some like skulls behind it, and then some fire coming up off of the bottom of the cauldron like it's on fire. Can you hear me good? Does it sound all right? I'm trying a different like microphone setup, so if you can't hear me good, just let me know. I'll switch it. But anyway, I got a canvas here. Oh, that was a bug. I just squashed a bug on the canvas. But yeah, so I'm just gonna go ahead and we're gonna start freehanding it on here. I have some air. Kind of low volume. Cool, like me, I sound low. Let me know if that's any better. It'll probably sound good if I'm standing up, but I don't want to be standing up. Anyway, yeah, this is something I'm just kind of doing for myself. Might turn it into shirts. I don't know. We'll see how it turns out. But for now, I'm just going to start with some little bit of black here. Gonna use some illustration, opaque black. That's the spot. Alright, so again, I have it sketched out over here, and I'm just gonna kind of freehand it in really lightly, just with some overly reduced black, you know, just so it's nice and light. And hopefully we can get it all in there. Start with the cauldron. Should probably run about right there. That's there. Right on, Dennis. We'll see you later, man. I'll be here. I'll be here.
Cool.
Yo, what's up, James? How's it going? Turn this back down. How's it going, man? Hopefully you can hear me good. Let me know how the sound is. If I need to go get my headphones, I will. Got got you guys up on the big screen today. So there's been some changes here in the little setup. Made it easier to get the stencils kind of more streamlined in and out for when you order a stencil. I'm kind of getting things ready for the launch of the new line of stencils. Also cleaned up the whole art area, so everything over here is a little more organized. All the paints are more organized so that I can get to the streaming again and transition over to just my art, which I'm kind of excited about. Sounds good. Cool. Cool, cool. What are you painting on? What are you working on? Put some little skull shapes. Thank you. for socks. American flag with an eagle. That's cool.
Thank you.
this one just for you. Actually, this one I'm turning into shirts. For sure. It's, yeah. I ordered some shirts for myself. They should be here sometime soon. I don't know. They use DHL, which it's always the worst. Like, out of all of them, right? It's like USPS and then UPS and then FedEx is like, if you must send me something, like, this is the order, right? USPS is like really reliable to me. UPS, again, after that, like, they're pretty good. And then FedEx after that is like, they don't hit their deadline, their projected date, nothing. Today, FedEx delivered something to us across the street, not to our house. And then at the very end after that, if you want to send me something, DHL is the, by far the worst way. So they shipped it out using DHL, but I really want to see the quality of these printed shirts. So yeah, I'll be able to share that with you guys. We're going back to the shirts and stuff. I'm probably going to start retiring some of the old designs, like some of the original ones. Start taking those off, start putting up new designs. And then cycle them in and out, you know, depending on the time of year or whatever we have going. So that's kind of what I'm thinking right now. If you haven't seen, underneath the video, right, there's those shirts. There's the OG Skull Squad shirt, and that's the one I ordered for myself. So we'll have to see how that goes. Because I don't get them for free either, so... Again, if you notice too, I switched it only to the premium shirts and the premium hoodies. I figured it'd make it easier, right? So like everybody could just order a shirt instead of having to go through like all the stuff, because it was just really setting everything up weird. And there's no point in ordering a non-premium shirt that's probably not gonna last as long, or the shirt's gonna shrink or get weird after you wash it, you know? So I just made it a little easier on the choices. And like I said, we'll have to cycle those in and out. Like when the summer comes, obviously, maybe we'll put some tank tops up on the store as well. Yeah, but for now, I think the shirts and the hoodies is probably a good choice for winter. So. Oh, yeah. It's starting to take shape. You ever just see something in your head for so long that you're just like, man, I really want to put that on paper, and then you finally get to doing it, and then you're just like, wow, that's exactly like I was thinking in my head. I even made sure to sketch it to make sure I didn't forget, and then now I'm like executed. I'm not having even looked over at my sketch now. It's just like, whatever, I'll just... Thank you.
cloth.
Mixing up some gray. Is it looking good? You should bring me a water. Let me get a rag real quick. The one thing I didn't leave lying here was a rag. Oh, you did hear me.
Yeah, I
heard
the popcorn.
Oh. I wasn't sure if you did. I was like, I don't think she heard me.
It's cold out here.
Is it?
Mm-hmm. Is it heating or if you're not cold, then I'm not
good. Unplug Alexa and put it in.
Is it cold?
It is getting chilly in here. It is.
Thank you.
quiet in the stream? Yeah, it makes it easy to clean when I just roll it up and then sweep and everything and blow it out and then unroll it again. And it's longer than the other one too. That one reaches like far, far. It's 50 feet, so it goes like all the way out into the middle of that lot over there. Okay. what's up, Heather? How's it going? Sorry, so focused I just haven't even looked. How's it going? How's it going? Yeah, it's been going good. COVID getting out of control again. Same old stuff other than that. I hope you're doing good. Thank you. out, so we have it all sketched out. We kind of have it colored in. So I'm just going to color the background black because I want the background on this to be black. Kind of want it for black or dark shirts. So I'm just going to go ahead and I'm not too worried about these because I'm just going to go back and highlight them real quick with some white, and then we're going to add fire, right? It's coming off of this and around, so the fire is going to really eat up some of this detail anyway. for another round of outline and shading. Get it looking really good. Thank you. through some white highlights, then we can focus on our fire. Gotta make sure I rinse this out really good. This popcorn is bomb. Bring me some. Bomb.com. Don't put websites in the chat. You don't know what it links to. You don't want to be like that teacher. She's just teasing everybody with the popcorn. I don't even have some, Jane, so don't feel bad. Poor lady. Who are you calling a lady? Of abuse I have to put up with, guys calling me names and stuff. Who are you calling a lady? Thank you. Yes, homemade caramel corn, so delicious.
Bam, son, where'd you find this?
Yeah.
So I reduced this white so it's not super duper bright. We're still going to add the flames. And once I add the flames, I'll come back with some unreduced white, some opaque white, and we'll really get those nice little fine hairs and just all the little white brights at the very, very end. Just so that they don't get muddled with any other color. Real quick, I'm just gonna you guys a quick look from the front, since you guys are kind of at a weird angle. Quick look from the front sees. So I'm just gonna go ahead and mix up some red, and we'll get ready to start on these fire flames. This real fire. What's up, Easy Airbrush? How's it going, man? I'm really digging this new setup. check it out. I don't know how many of you guys follow on Instagram, but I actually got you guys up on the big screen today, right there, so I could read the chat without having to squint my eyes and like trying to see it from far away on the little screen. I've got all the Createx colors set up there. More on this table over here. There's all my regular line of Createx service colors, illustration colors, and candy colors are up on the shelf. And then if we go all the way around this way, there we have the stencil station. And then way up on the top over here, there we have all the 4050 Createx clear and stuff. So it looks pretty nice in here. Right now, we'll see how long it lasts. So again, I'm just going to start off with a little bit of a pack red. Again, I have lots of videos explaining how to do the fire. If you're watching this video later on and you're wondering where that video is, drop a comment down below or whatever and I'll make sure to link you to it. If you're interested, if you haven't already seen it, super organized and very professional, yeah. Like I said, we'll see how long that lasts. Thank you though, thank you. Let's try to make it look good. Hopefully we get some new videos here soon and also for the live streams. I'm gonna have some different angles coming once I get the cameras all hooked up and everything again. I'm just kind of slowly but surely working it back into shape in here. Gonna make another video about the Camaro here in the next couple days. I'm still kind of waiting on news on another potential sponsor, so we'll see how that goes. You know, fingers crossed. It's a pretty big one. I'm pretty sure you guys will like it. And again, I'm just trying to make that car as dope as possible, and we're gonna try to take it around next year to the car shows and maybe around the country, so you guys could all check it out, try to bring it closer to you guys, you know, try to take it coast to coast. Because the local car shows are nice, but um, it's always like the same people, right? So you kind of, I kind of want to mix it up. There's also a lot of people I really want to meet that I've never met. So yeah, the only way to do all that is to get out and travel, son. So hopefully next year we could do some of that. So I don't know how we're going to do it just quite yet, but Createx is in Connecticut, right? So it's like all the way, I'm in Colorado, they're in Connecticut. Somehow, some way, I want to take the Camaro all the way to Connecticut to the Createx, headquarters, maybe shoot some videos there, get it like an interview with maybe Chris Arpin or something. Have them look over the car, take shots of the car or whatever. And then along the way or on the way back is to stop at some events or something like that, that maybe we could, if we could all link up somehow. Different areas, you know. What's up, Ray Evans? How's it going? Welcome to the Skull Squad, sir. Thank you. It's looking pretty good. It's looking all right. It's getting there. I think that would be a pretty good plan for next year. I don't know, this year kind of COVID ruined everything, right? Everything I had planned as far as going to markets and shows and doing all that jazz. And luckily the year still kind of worked out, thanks to Createx, thanks to all you guys, all the customers that put in different orders that usually It's not that I don't do that kind of stuff, it's usually I don't have time to do that kind of stuff. But this year, we got a lot of cars done, just a lot of little stuff, and yeah, it was pretty good to get all that and still have a good year, So. Hopefully next year we could all meet together, shoot, even if I have to do some kind of event here and you guys all come here or something. But my goal is to somehow take that car next year and take it all the way up to Connecticut. Createx is up there, HD Stencils is up there, so it'd be nice to get an interview with them, with him. Whichever you want to say, and like I said, stuff along the way, the St. Louis Bridge is along the way, stuff like that, and, it'd be cool to take Violet so she could, kind of get out, get pictures of her with stuff, and just in general, travel a little bit, even if it's only for a week real quick, just to get out of the house, be nice. before I forget to, if you're a member of the Skull Squad, level 2 or higher, and you know what? If you're a member of the Skull Squad, period, go ahead and shoot me an email. Go over to the website, you know, mikesbrush.com, like it is right there. Find my email on there. Shoot me an email and send me your address, because the deadline for the HD Stencils collaboration is coming up. So if you want to make sure you have your stencil in time, go ahead and shoot me an email. Let me know what your YouTube name is, obviously, so I could check. Right now the plan is everybody on the level 2 or higher. So if you're paying $5 and you'll get an HD stencil, I'm going to send a couple sheets of, you know, sketch paper, some nice thick drawing paper that you can airbrush on. And yeah, we'll send it right out to your door, and that way when we do the lesson, you'll be ready and ready to go. So, but I'm not going to rule out doing the level 1 members yet. We'll just have to see how much level 2 we have. Right now we have allocated 30 spots, and I would like them to be 30 level 2 spots. Again, HD Stencils reached out, they want to do that. And I just want to make it worth it for myself and for everybody else, you know, involved to do level 2 and higher. And hopefully, if it works out pretty good, we can do more collabs with other stuff in other places. So, yeah. Yeah, it really is, you know, a good opportunity, especially for $5. You know, HD stencils are actually kind of, I wouldn't say they're so expensive, but they're like, you know, if you just want to try it, it can be expensive for just trying. So $5 is pretty cheap, and it'll have a lesson to go with it so that you can kind of understand how to use it. How to make the most of it. So Right on, James. I'll make sure to check your email. Yeah, $5 for an HD stencil. It's honestly a pretty good deal. And I'm just mixing up really bright high tone yellow so we can go ahead and give it one more layer of flames and really highlight these little skulls just a little bit. Maybe give them some detail here on his cheeks. Now let's just do some white highlights. Get you guys a good up front look real quick. All right, thank you, Heather, for the email. I'll make sure to get your address written down. All you guys. I have to wipe off the camera there. Right, so that's an up front shot so far. The difference of color from one screen to the other. It looks so good on the big screen, it looks really dull on the bottom screen. Good to know. Let's shoot some last coat of white. Last little white highlights. And we can wrap it up for today. And we'll be back Thursday with another how-to. Yeah. Damn, son, where'd you find this? Oh, yeah. That's really nice. Old Billy, you know, he helped a lady cross the street. That's really nice.
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
So the only thing I'm not super, super duper set on is the lack of red. Right? So I see a lot of orange, I see a lot of yellow, I see the green and the glow and all that, but I see a distinct lack of red on the fire. So I'm gonna go ahead and get some red candy and go ahead and go over that. Good night, James, man. Have a good night, bro. And then that'll be a wrap. I'm pretty happy with the way it turned out. Once we add the red, it's gonna look pretty good. So again, appreciate y'all joining me today for the chat, for the live stream. Like I said, we'll be back Thursday. If you want to be a part of the HD Stencils collab and have an HD stencil for yourself, please make sure you sign up for the Skull Squad. Level 2 tier, right? It's $5 a month. Level 2, you'll get access to all the videos that are on the channel, right? Early access. You'll get the HD Stencils collab and anything else that might come in. You also get access to the live stream anytime we live stream, so yeah. And the reason for having it as members only is because sometimes the non-members can make the chat quite, I want to say repetitive, but that's not really the word. Monotonous, the same. And this makes it all worthwhile for me. So, yeah. You want your questions answered? One good way to do that is join Skull Squad. And I just want to take this moment to thank our sponsors. So, as always, we got Createx Colors down here at the bottom left of your screen. They help provide all the paint for today and for most of the live streams. They actually sent over some new flesh tones and stuff that we'll be using for the artwork on the Camaro, as well as some of the live streams coming up, so you guys can check those out. And also to our sponsor Super Clean, which a lot of people ask, what do I use to rinse out my colors? Usually use a little bit of Super Clean. Works really good for that. Yeah, redundant. Redundant is a good word too. You guys that have been here a while know how the non-members can be, so I'm not, you know. Throwing that blood red candy all along the edge of our flame here, along our design, and it's turning all them yellow bits at the end into a nice red, kind of melting it in there at the edge. It looks really good. Much more happier with that. That That'll look, yeah, what paint do you use? That's a good one. So yeah, that'll make a good back to a shirt, right? This, put this on the back, probably make it say Skull Squad around here, something like that. And then, you know, have a nice Skull Squad design on the front. Maybe this same thing, but have it say Skull Squad a little differently for the front. That's kind of the theme right now is Skull Squad shirts. It's kind of what I want to design. Right on, guys, that'll end up today's stream. Again, as always, thank you guys for hanging out. If you're interested in getting yourself one of these shirts, make sure you just follow us on Instagram or Facebook. I'll be posting up a link to once I have it up and ready on the store, so you guys can see it. Let me get you guys a little closer here so you guys can see some of that. See you guys on Thursday. Have a good night, everybody. Again, thank you guys to all the Skull Squad members, Heather, James, Easy Airbrush, Air Todd, Ryan Evans, Gary Thornsberry, Justice, Robert Philichuk, Bill, dang, there's so many of you, I forget. There's always, I know I'm forgetting a few of them all the time, but thank all you guys for all the support. And we'll see you guys next time. Later.